Hi, everybody. Welcome to Valley Views, what you see and what you hear in the Coachella Valley. And there is so much going on in March. My goodness, the place to be is the BNP Baribus. Is that right, Gloria?
I think so.
It's such a fantastic tennis tournament. I'm not into tennis, but when Jennifer Capriati was here, I was there every day, and it was amazing then, and it's amazing now. And that is March 5th through the 18th. We have A Jew Grows in Brooklyn from the Heart of Broadway. It's a smash comedy hit, and it's fantastic at the Annenberg Theater, and that's March 7th through the 25th. And, of course, on the 17th, we have Faith and Begora, Close to Our Own Heart, at the Renaissance Esmeralda, and it benefits COD, and they're so amazing in everything they do there. Robin Montgomery sent me this. I think it's so important. Everything you hear about is just, you know, made every place else, but what about the USA? So she says green toys, they're toys for kids, all kinds of toys for all ages, and all made right here in the USA. Texas Jeans, and they're opening on El Paseo soon. They make over 90 styles, and they're all made in Texas. Footskin, it's a Made in America sheepskin-lined slipper that has everyone, oh my goodness, taking its fabulous, fabulous made here. And then there's Discovery Home Dog Beds, made here, not in China. And just so many things, but it's, you know what? To be honest with you, I am now driving a car that's made in America, and it makes me feel a whole lot better. Thank you, Jessup Cadillac. This is one of my favorites. Every guy thinks that every girl's dream is to find the perfect guy. Baloney. Every girl's dream is to eat without getting fat. Let's see who's on our show today. I am thrilled to have my very own Gigi, Gloria Greer. And we go way, way, way back. And her daughter, Norma Greer Fishkind, and the fabulous Richard DeSantis. We're going to talk about Do You Feel the Love Tonight, the Act for MS Spring Gala. We'll hear all about that. And from United Way's Rockin VIP Challenge, oh goodness, it's Frank Orlett and Linda Evans. We have some archives, go way, way, way back with Valley Views. And we have Teen Talk with Alexis Safoyan. We have a lot. Hope you can sit back, relax, enjoy Valley Views, and we will be right back.
Win your fortune!
At Spotlight 29, every Friday, you have a chance to win your share of up to 12 grand. Starting at 6 p.m. on Fridays, you can win your fortune. And with a cash drawing every 20 minutes till 9:40 p.m., this is your chance to win your share of up to 12 grand. But you have to be here to win. So get to Spotlight 29 on Fridays to
win your fortune.
Spotlight 29 Casino, the Valley's best bet.
To you, it's just a guitar no one plays anymore. But when you donate it or any item to Angel View, we'll use the proceeds to help some severely disabled young people. Angel View, because we can all use an angel in our lives, once in a while.
Patty Daly Caruso here for Out of the Box Gold Store, home of the 30-day guarantee.
I'm so curious. Tell me about the 30-day guarantee.
Well, Patty, if you sell your items today, and within 30 days if gold, silver, or platinum goes up, we're going to pay you the difference.
The best price, guaranteed. This takes a lot of the guesswork out. Price goes up, you give me the difference.
I mean, nobody is doing this.
Well, I got to go. I'm going to go home and get all my stuff.
Come into Out of the Box Gold Store today, the Valley's premier precious metal dealer.
The fabulous Gloria Greer, what can I say? Needs no introduction. She is the founder and president of Act for MS, and she is right here to my right. And to her right is Richard DeSantis, and Richard is producing the fabulous show, and he is on the board for MS, and his wife has, we'll talk about that. And Norma Greer Fishkind is Gloria's daughter, and she is the reason that there is an Act for MS. And how are you doing?
Great.
You are good.
Great.
Yes.
God is good.
God is great.
Act
God
for
is
MS
good.
Is good.
Look at that smile, and that's why, because you know she's doing well.
That's correct.
And you've done so much.
Well, I mean, it's grown so tremendously from when Norma came to me, and she couldn't walk. She was in a wheelchair, and she knew that there were other people who had multiple sclerosis locally. And she said, we have to do something to help those people. So, you know, unlike the national organization, which does great work for research and so on.
Sure.
Our mission was absolutely help the local people.
I
and
love
we're
that.
Changing lives.
Mm-hmm.
Richard
you
can tell us about that as well as moi. Mm-hmm. But anyway, it's so gratifying. I'll go someplace someone I've never, don't even know, will come up to me and say, you don't know how this has changed my life.
Oh, my goodness.
And that's the exercise, which is tailored to the individual. And other things that actually Richard's wife, Lynn, she may have MS, but boy, has she made a change. I mean, you know, these people, they're doing their own newsletter.
Uh-huh.
We have a resource center. They're learning how to use Dragon. They're, if they can't talk, they can't do, they can talk, but they can't do that.
Right.
It's just amazing.
It is.
Truly. So we have an event March 31st.
Yay!
We want everybody, all your viewers, please come join us.
Good, good. Tell us about the event.
Absolutely. Well, I have to make this up as we go along because we're working on the show right now. John Bayless is going to be our central performer. He's being both honored and he's going to perform, and he's probably going to do a duet with himself.
Okay.
Bill did a duet with his dad last year.
Bill Marx, Harpo Marx, for those who don't know.
Oh, yes, his father, Harpo Marx. We use a little technology that allows people to do some funny things. So John and I were debating whether to call it Piano for Three Hands or not. You know, we thought it was sort of the unusual way to go. We'll also have lots of other music. Doc Poster will have his orchestra there, and he's already written a nice overture of Elton John music, and we'll be featuring Elton John music. And we will have some surprise new entertainers, as we have every year.
I think that's so great.
May I say something about John Bayless?
Yes, please do.
Maybe your viewers don't know John. John Bayless is an extraordinary performer. He is a pianist, he is a composer, and he is a recording artist. And aside from all the classical, he's played with every major symphony orchestra and at every, from Carnegie Hall to the Hollywood Bowl and throughout the world.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the things that he's known for is as a what they call a crossover performer. And that would be where you take the classics.
Okay.
One of his big selling albums several years ago was the Beatles meets Bach.
Oh.
And his Elton John is called Circle of Life. And there was a PBS show on that,
mm-hmm.
as well as the CD. And it's just tremendous. 2 years ago, though, he had a stroke.
Oh, he did.
He had a stroke. And how he has adjusted. He does not play now with two hands. He plays with one.
Oh.
Better than most people with two.
Oh, goodness.
He is composing again. He is doing master classes. He is doing concerts, and the reason it act for MS, he never had MS, but it's proof that you can have a disability
mm-hmm.
and go on with your life and do great things.
Isn't that wonderful?
So we are so proud to honor John Bayless, and he will perform, as Richard said, with two hands and then with one hand together.
And you know
Yay!
What? When you said that, I kind of, for a moment, went, what? Huh?
What?
Three hands. But yeah. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. No, he's extraordionary.
We're looking
and he's
forward.
A fairly young man, by the way.
Yeah, we're looking forward to it. Being able to do a piano duet with either your father, who's no longer here, or with yourself on screen is always kind of an interesting experience for the performer.
Yeah, and this is on the 31st.
On the 31st of March. It's a Saturday night at the Renaissance Esmeralda.
Yeah, I love things
Emerald
there.
Emerald Ballroom. And we're using the theme, You Feel the Love Tonight, which is from the Circle of Life that he did, but that's Elton John, and it's the Lion King. And we're grabbing that theme, the jungle theme. I have someone's bought two tables.
I love it.
With a jungle thing that they're going to wear costumes.
Oh,
it's going to be such fun.
You know, it's just too bad you're not really excited about it.
No, I know.
I love it. I love, love, love. I love you. Okay, so tell us how you're doing. How has the trip been for you, the journey?
The journey? Since finding that I could get better through weight training, and if I slip, I can go back to the weight training and maybe not do it as at the level I was at, but then build up again. It's amazing. I don't know why, but the brain doesn't want to work, but when you do the weight training, the brain doesn't have to work. The body does the work.
Fantastic.
I guess. I don't know.
Yeah. And they're doing a lot in research, right?
Oh, I guess so. But that's not our mission.
I know, but still, it's wonderful to know Yeah. I had an email from Patrick McCarthy.
Oh yes.
And all of the pins were across there for breast cancer, for cancer, for all of the things, and it was just a plea to keep the candle burning. And it's wonderful to know that each day something miraculous may happen.
We are grateful
for
that.
One of the illnesses.
Right. Yeah. But of course, the thing about MS is there no one knows why people get it.
Yeah.
And there is no cure. So our budget is tremendous. It's almost $400,000 now because none of our clients pay for anything. We pay for everything for them. The training and the different events that we sponsor, it gives them a life.
Yes.
You know, if you're disabled, at first you're shocked and you don't want to leave the house.
And it could happen to anybody.
Yeah, that's right.
In light of the fact that there is no cure, we're really about disease management. We help people learn how to manage their lives despite the fact that they have MS.
Mm-hmm.
And all of the programs that we have are geared toward enriching everybody's life.
How long has your wife dealt with it?
She was diagnosed in 1992, but before that, probably about 15 years before that, we noticed some symptoms. We just didn't know what they were.
Mm-hmm.
And so she's had MS, obviously, for quite a while. And despite all of the issues that she's working through, she continues. She amazes me.
Yeah.
She's incredible.
Really. Yeah. She amazes me.
Yeah.
Yeah, because Norma works with her all the time. And there's a newsletter that they all put out, and Norma works on it, but it was Lynn's idea for these people who have MS to do their own newsletter. And that's really hard for them to do.
Of course.
And it's very good.
And it's all done with Dragon voice-activated software. Right.
And clients.
Clients, yes.
Not the board this time. The clients are actually
clients
putting
are
out the newsletter.
Right. You guys are amazing. It's going to be a wonderful event, the 31st of March.
Right.
And I love, love, love that you're so excited to have John Bayless with you.
Oh, he's wonderful.
That's fantastic.
Be there, be
Thanks
square.
Thanks for coming
Thank
today.
You,
be there
Patty.
And be square. You heard it right here. Be right back.
Indulge yourself today at Al Michaels Eterna Salon and Medical Day Spa. We offer everything from laser hair removal, injectable fillers, and skin rejuvenation, specializing in medical and cosmetic aspects of dermatology, using state-of-the-art techniques in diagnosis and treatment of skin conditions. Whether you're looking for professional hair, makeup, nails, tanning, skin and body treatments, let us bring out the beauty in you. Al Michaels Eterna Salon and Medical Day Spa in Indian Wells.
Please join Patty Daly Caruso for the 8th Annual Faith and Begora Fashion Show and Dinner on March 17th at the Renaissance Esmeralda in Indian Wells. Call 760-346-3363 for tickets and more information. This event will benefit College of the Desert Foundation.
Spotlight 29. Every Friday, you have a chance to win your share of up to 12 grand. Starting at 6 p.m. on Fridays, you can win your fortune. And with a cash drawing every 20 minutes till 9:40 p.m., this is your chance to win your share of up to 12 grand. But you have to be here to win. So get to Spotlight 29 on Fridays to
win your fortune.
Spotlight 29 Casino, the Valley's best bet.
Jumping right into it, it's called the Rockin' VIP Challenge, and it is every year one of the most fun events. Actually, we'll find out they've changed the name and a couple of things. Just, you know, every now and then you do something, makes it a little bit better even. And to my right is Alison Eisner, and she is the executive director. And to her right is Frank Orlett. He is the president of the board of United Way, and he's also... Oh, my gosh, every time I see a big Burtek truck, I know that everything's just fine because he's the district manager.
That's true.
That's what I have to say to him. And big job, because what did you do? It always was the VIP Waiter Challenge.
It was always, yes, the VIP Waiter Challenge, and we've changed it. We kind of took the waiter out of it, and it's just a VIP challenge because everybody there is a VIP.
I like that.
It's not
That's
just individual
cool.
VIPs, it's everybody.
Yeah. And your event's on March 23rd.
March 23rd. It's going to be rocking. It's going to be exciting.
60s, 70s, and 80s.
60s, 70s, and 80s. You can do it from any of those eras. And it's a great event to kind of let your hair down a little bit. It's not a boring event, boring fundraiser. It's a fundraiser, but it helps local charities. But it's just fun.
That's the thing. The United Way is just... always there, just amazing.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And how are you, Missy?
I am just fine, my friend. Yeah, we've made some exciting changes this year with Frank and Linda Evans as our event chairs this mm-hmm. year. It's on a Friday instead of a Monday, so people can actually stay a little later and dance till the end of the night, you know, on a Monday.
Tell us the group.
The group. I'll let Frank tell you. I love the Zippers. Yeah.
It's a very, very good band.
Great band.
It's going to be... It's going to be rocking. It's going to be exciting.
Uh-huh.
And we kept, you notice though, we kept the name Challenge as part of the title
yes.
of the event. So there will be challenges and costume and table host challenges and all of that with voting opportunities and things like that. So that's still part of the fun.
Because I mean, there are prizes for best costume and table decor.
Right.
And they can have a lot of fun with 60s, 70s, and 80s.
Exactly. And yeah, that table decor imagine. Is a big part of it.
I remember walking into the ballroom one night, and I don't remember who did it, but it was phenomenal. It was all Hawaiian. I mean, I felt like I should be doing a hula dance. You know, I mean, they really, really get into it.
They really do. They go all out, and they become these little... miniature like movie sets
yeah.
almost
I
at
know.
Each table. And I know you've done it for so many years.
Yes, well, and we did win twice.
Oh, my that's goodness. Right. That's
Thank
right.
you, Judy Vossler. Yes, we were, what were we? We were the prom queens from yesteryear or whatever.
Yes, which
tacky
would be great.
Again.
Tacky. Yeah. I was not going to mention that word, but that's what we were, actually. We had a lot of fun doing it.
It was very fun.
Actually,
you guys
that'd, be a great, that'd be a great one for this
we
year.
We were thinking it would fit mm-hmm. in perfectly for you this year.
Yeah, yeah. We'll have to get together and figure that out. Okay. Tell us what you do with the funds that you make.
Well, basically, you know, United Way of the Desert, what we do, all the funds stay local, first
Which
of all.
I love,
so,
by the way.
Yeah, I think it's really important for people to know that that's, you know, they're not going outside the valley. So any of these proceeds will be directed towards our efforts to support the 20-some charities that we, you know, provide funding to. And they have a very rigorous application process, and that's... taking place once a year. It's actually taking place right now. And
see, that's hard. That's
yeah.
really difficult because everybody is needs the help.
That's right. That's yeah. right. It's really tough. So we do want to encourage people that as much as this is a fun, you know, festive, celebratory event, there really is a very serious need behind it. And it really makes a difference in hundreds of thousands of people's lives here in the desert mm-hmm. each year, you know, because these go to help people eat and get medical care and emergency care and, you know, things like that.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, it's really critical.
Well, it's interesting because obviously there are so many invitations to so many events. And frankly, if mine comes and it's really fancy and it really costs a whole lot.
Right.
I kind of go, some of that money might have gone to the, you know, and then when you go to the event and it's, so I love when the money stays in the Coachella Valley
exactly.
and helps the people here.
That's right. And it is a fine line. You know, you want to see something
Absolutely.
With some effort
want everybody
into it,
to do
but,
well.
But you don't want it to, you know, you don't
yeah.
want it too
no.
ritzy and
yeah.
glossy and
no,
all
this
that.
This is
yeah.
fabulous.
Yeah.
So dare we ask what you're going to be this year?
Always a surprise.
Always a surprise.
Always a surprise.
We can't get any kind of scoop on Valley Views. Frank Orlett, maybe the night before the event he'll tell us, but we can't tell you because... You'll have already seen the show, but I like being surprised, so that's okay. That's good.
We enjoy it. It's a wonderful, wonderful event. We had a great time, and it's nice to because it's local folks doing local things.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Thank you both so much for coming to share.
Thank you for
Can't
all
wait
your involvement.
To see you that night.
Thanks for having
figure,
us.
I'll figure out who you are.
I've always had a big crush on you, by the way, but don't tell my wife.
Did you hear that? Did you hear that? You just made my day.
Wow.
We'll be back if I can tear myself away from these two.
Welcome to Out of the Box Gold Store. If you've got unwanted gold, silver, or platinum, this is the place to go.
Okay, big decision.
Tell me about this whole process, what you do with it.
We do everything right in front of you, and while we're doing this, you're learning and getting an education of how this all works.
Go to a place you can trust.
This one here says 14 karat, so I know this is 14 karat. I have ultrasound machines, water density. We have certified scales.
That's so fantastic. Come into Out of the Box Gold Store today, home of the 30-day guarantee.
To you, it's just a guitar no one plays anymore. But when you donate it or any item to Angel View, we'll use the proceeds to help some severely disabled young people. Angel View, because we can all use an angel in our lives, once in a while.
Indulge yourself today at Al Michaels Eterna Salon and Medical Day Spa. We offer everything from laser hair removal, injectable fillers, and skin rejuvenation, specializing in medical and cosmetic aspects of dermatology, using state-of-the-art techniques in diagnosis and treatment of skin conditions. Whether you're looking for professional hair, makeup, nails, tanning, skin and body treatments, let us bring out the beauty in you. Al Michaels Eterna Salon and Medical Day Spa in Indian Wells.
Hi, I'm Alexis Safoyan. Welcome to Teen Talk. First up today, we have the Key Club, which is a community service club found in most high schools. They meet about 2 times a month, and they're required to do 5 to 7 hours of community service. Their main focus is on ethical behavior and community service. They cooperate with school principals, teachers, other students, and people in need. In an interview with the principal, I found that he was so enthusiastic, and the students were too, about how grateful everyone is that they are participating in this organization. So for more information, go to keyclub.org or just talk to anyone at your local high school. Next, baseball is in full swing. Actually, players work about 15 hours a week, working for games, training, stuff like that. In an interview with Coach Claggett, they talk about how physical ability, self-discipline, self-esteem, and teamwork are all worked on during the sport. Coaches, you know, really become mentors for the kids and leaders that they can look up to. The season is February to May, and you can find the schedules and rosters on maxpreps.com or on, you know, the high school's websites. Come see a game or two or volunteer. There's tons of ways that you can help out. Last, we have chamber singers. About 30 kids in each school participate in the chamber singers, and they can travel, compete, and perform. In fact, some people have traveled to China, Italy, New York's Carnegie Hall, Australia, and San Francisco participating in the events. About 60 hours of fundraising are required for the families of the chamber singers to help with vocal music programs and travel expenses for the competitions. If you love to travel and sing, it's perfect for you. Everyone really becomes a family, or so they say, and it's really an exciting event. So auditions are at the end of the year if you're interested, and it's a full year project. My closing tip for the day is definitely encourage kids to get involved in some type of a club or a sport. In fact, it's proven that high attendance, lower dropout rates, and fewer disciplinary incidents have happened. So thank you, and have a great March.
Thank you, Alexis.
Thank you.
How great is she? Love that you keep us, you know, dialed into what's going on in the teen world. Thanks so much.
Thank you for having me.
And we're going to take a look at one of our archive pieces from a long, long time ago on Valley Views, and then Father Lincoln. You know, it has been said that there is only one thing in the whole world that's better than a Jim Murray column, and that's a Jim Murray book. You know you're my hero, and you know I'm excited, right?
If I'm going to be anybody's hero, I want to be your hero.
When I read your column, I have my scissors there to cut and clip and keep, because I can't possibly let it go away. How do you do it?
I need the money. I have to do it. You know, we don't really get a choice.
But so consistently wonderful, truly.
Well, aren't you nice? They're not consistently wonderful, but it's nice if you think they are.
You've traveled the whole world over. You've met every sports celebrity, every celebrity. Are there any that are especially outstanding?
Sports celebrities? Yeah, when I think of sports, I think of Ben Hogan immediately. I think Hogan was probably as close as any to being my idol.
Mm-hmm.
He really introduced me to golf. And I did a cover story on him in Time magazine many years ago and had to follow him around for a while and achieved an enormous respect for Ben Hogan. And he dramatized golf. I mean, you almost felt sorry for the golf course when Hogan was stalking it. You know, he was really a presence on a golf course.
Mm-hmm. And you love golf.
I love golf. Yeah, it doesn't love me. It's unrequited.
Have you ever had a hole-in-one?
Yes, I had a hole-in-one on the 16th at Riviera. On November 4th, 1970. And the hole is 138 yards long, so I cut a little driver in there and it went right in the hole.
Well, I know somebody else who had a hole-in-one on the 16th, and that was your partner today up at Ironwood.
Mr. Dick Caruso.
Yeah.
He's had 3 holes-in-1 on that hole.
Well, see, I didn't want to brag, yeah. But it's true.
Well, you can't brag about a hole-in-1. It's the most completely accidental thing in the history of mankind.
All of us have noticed that when someone is arrested, reporters are very careful to state that
It is only an allegation that the man or the woman did so-and-so. In our system of justice, we are presumed innocent until we're proven guilty before a jury of our peers. There is no rush to judgment. But in our own lives, when we look at people, I think that sometimes we do rush to judgment. For example, let's suppose someone has a lot of tattoos, or wears a nose ring, or has a ponytail. What is your rush to judgment? What is your first image of them? Or what about, let's go to another extreme, what about rich people, that top 1%? What is your image of them? What do you think? Or even people that work in a church, do you think they'd be fun to have at your parties? Or what is your judgment when you first meet a priest? Believe me, I know people rush to judgments when it comes to my vocation. Rash judgment is coming to a conclusion before all the facts are known. And unfortunately, it's a fault that even good people can fall into. We hear a rumor about someone and we accept it as truth. We see a man having lunch with a woman who is not his wife, and we conclude that they are having an affair. My mother used to always say that we can judge a man by his clothes, but I don't think that's true. Passing judgment is risky. So I think all of us should think twice before passing judgment on anyone. In most all matters, a person should be innocent in our eyes until he has been judged guilty, not by a jury, but by the all-knowing and just judge, God Himself.
Thank you, Father Lincoln, Father Howard Lincoln, Sacred Heart Church. I want to thank all my guests today, and I want to thank you for joining us. Till we meet again, remember, yesterday's history, tomorrow's a mystery. Today's a gift, and that's why we call it the present. Live in the now moment, enjoy our valley views, those you see and those you hear. Take good care and keep smiling. It's contagious. Peace, love, joy, faith. God bless. Hope to see you soon at one of the fabulous events in March here in the Coachella Valley.